Hello everyone, welcome to a painting tutorial by Staticgrass Creation. My name is Jason and today I will be painting a Cryx Helljack, the Slayer from War Machine. Most of the paints I'm using are from Games Workshop. Some are P3 paints from Privateer Press, and then Filthy Suit is from Army Painter. The Slayer is from the 3-in-1 Helljack set, so the arms have been magnetized. To start, I have primed the model black. I base coat the Slayer with Army Painter's Filthy Suit. This gray is equivalent to Games Workshop's Dawnstone. I thin the paint a little so that about 2 or 3 layers would make a good coat over the model. Next, I paint the trim, spikes, and limbs steel with Games Workshop's Lead Belcher. The first wash used is Agrax Earthshade, which I apply heavily over the gray armor, allowing some pooling to occur. Once the brown wash is completely dry, a black wash, using Nullen oil, is applied liberally over the steel and the armor. The last wash I use is Beal Tan Green. This wash is used sparingly in random locations on the armor. Next, I paint the vents using Privateer's Ordic Olive. I layer on Games Workshop's Warboss Green, as well as paint the eyes. Using Moot Green, I finish off the vents with a final highlighting layer. I paint the tusks, talons, claws, and exhaust armor with warp lock bronze. I finish the steel with a highlighting dry brush of Privateer Press's Cryx Slayer. Now, for what I wanted to show off, Games Workshop's technical paint, Nihilakh Oxide. This particular paint is already on the liquidy side, so there's no need to water it down. I'm applying it to the areas of the Slayer that I painted with Warplock Bronze. I'm essentially painting it on as a thin layer, removing paint when it's in excess. I want to get it into the recesses, around the bolts, and into holes. Rather than just drying matte, the paint will have a chalky look to it when it dries. The effect I'm trying to emulate is oxidized iron. I think it looks quite convincing. Thank you. Using Abaddon Black, I fill in the exhaust pipes and fix up the base. Orboss Green is painted on one half of the base to indicate the facing. Once the green is dry, I apply white glue to the inside of the base and spread it with a modeling tool. I finish off the Slayer by basing it with Snowflock. And there you have it, a completed Cryx Slayer. With my newfound appreciation with the technical paints, I will probably be using them a lot more often. If you like what you see, give this video a like and don't forget to subscribe. Stay tuned for more painting tutorials. Thanks for watching.